The idea being, you see, that each epoch being shorter than the one that preceded it, this generates an asymptotic curve of approach. And it's become a cliche of our culture that time is speeding up. It actually is speeding up. It's not that it seems like it's speeding up, or it looks like it's speeding up. It is speeding up. We and our entire world are being drawn into confrontation with something that at this level is lost below the event horizon of rational apprehension. That's a fancy way of saying you can't know jack shit about it at this point in time. There will come a moment when it will rise above the horizon of rational apprehension. I think that history is a set of nested resonances. This is what I mean when I say nothing is unannounced. Nothing can take you by surprise if you've really been paying attention, because everything is preceded by its harbingers and heralds. And we are living in an era now where there is a great deal of apocalyptic expectation, anticipation, and hysteria for several reasons. First of all, because Christianity just is hysterical in all times and places. Second of all, there's a built-in goose in the calendar because we're approaching a millennial year, and that always exacerbates this Christian thing outrageously because of the promise made, you know, amen, amen, I say to you, this generation shall not pass away before I return to, you know, clean your plow or whatever it is. And there is the physical evidence all around us that we are the witnesses to a planetary crisis that we cannot control or manage. I mean, it's very hard to believe that we could manage ourselves back into a steady state. I mean, yeah, the Jews are talking to the Arabs and they're trying to get things straightened out in South Africa, but what about the global population curve? What about the degrading atmosphere? I mean, you know, you don't necessarily, you're just as dead even if you're not killed by a racist or a fascist. So we can get certain problems under control, but it seems certain problems are beyond our control. Also, there's another level to all this, which is when you take cores from the Greenland ice, or make side-ranging radar maps of the Canadian Shield, you discover that we are not the only force for disruption and chaos wandering around the universe looking for trouble. The universe is an incredibly chaotic and unstable place. Planetesimal impacts on the Earth have reset the biological clock at least three times in the last billion years. What we have been living through for the past 50,000 years is an unusual era of metastability, and it has allowed us to create a global civilization. But we can't assume that we have 50,000 years of stability ahead of us, or even 100,000 years of stability ahead of us. And finally, you know, this curious resistance to the idea of the end of the world always amuses me, because maybe the world will end and maybe it won't end. But have you ever noticed that the end of your world is an absolute certainty? You're going to go into the yawning grave, and rather soon, I should suspect, and possibly sooner than you're prepared for. So quibbling over the end of other people's world seems like a philosophical argument compared to the certainty of your own finality. Yeah.